Artyom, Gil and I will soon be leaving, so you can take some rest, do a checkup on your gear, and catch up with us. We'll rendezvous at their base.
Artyom, we're fixing to leave already, but there's one thing that keeps nagging on me. Remember that dismantled ship I told you about? I can't stop thinking about the slaves they keep there. Do you think we could still free them? If not us, then who? So tired of this dust. Can't wait to get out of here. Don't take dumb risks there. I need a live husband, not a dead hero.
Artyom, the car's near the Aurora. Yermak, you sure the pipes will hold? Yeah, we'll have to run them through the whole carriage.
Uncle Artyom, Uncle Artyom! I drank so much water! It's slashing in my belly now. You drink some too. Grandpa Yermak says you can drink as much as you want now. We'll also have tea.
They should. Our pumps aren't that good. Can't build much of a pressure, so I don't expect leaks. Some seepage at worst. Once we get far enough, we'll move the pipes to the roof and then replace them with proper metal ones.
Well, you're on top of things, having so many spare parts, Blin. Even pipes. And you brought them from Moscow.
It never hurts to have more spares. Besides, I just knew they'd come in handy. Hansa supplied every sortie so well, we could build a second engine with the spares.
Yeah, we could build a second one, but didn't have enough to fix the first at the Volga.
Well, you can't foresee everything.
Hi, Artyom! Well, it's all gonna be okay now. We can't lose now that we have water. You guys did great!
Artyom, watch out while on the mission. We'll be praying for you.
Oh, come on. It's Artyom we're talking about. He's made of steel. Just listen to him walk.
But yeah, man. You better keep both your eyes open out there. Cavalry will be there in the nick of time, of course, but don't go taking unnecessary risks.
his soul. That cretin. Driving around, I guess. When did I even give him a car? I don't remember. I shouldn't have. That man's an idiot. Complete cretin. Who the hell did you bring here, you cretins? Why is he armed? And where the fuck is Saul? Incompetent fools. Ah, he's one of the newcomers. Huh. Color me intrigued. Good, good. Everybody, save for the guest. Out. Cretins. Ah. Thank you for this wise decision. Well, young man, now we can talk with masks off, huh? I take you didn't expect to see me here, huh? It's hardly surprising. Nobody would expect that. Saul, the cretin that he is, sometimes does show surprising creativity. I have to give him that. Destroying what remains of the resistance, getting rid of the witch and rooting out treason in one fell swoop. This plan has grandeur. So that's why I'm sitting here. I don't even remember since how long. Looking at my property and listening to my double on the radio. That double has a way with the radio, I must say. Using him as a mere clay pigeon even seems like a waste. Ah, well. If anything, there's too many talents among my people. See this portrait? Does it even look like me? Of course it doesn't. The artist is a prime case of one talent too many. This cretin painted this off my double. Should have been a spitting image of me. But I don't even recognize this face. I can't remember where the painting came from either. No matter, though. Let's talk about something else. Guests and trains, for example. Oh, we've been waiting for you. We do have ears in the West, just like you have... used to have here. Don't take it personal, but all of your spies had to burn for offending the Holy Flame. A man's gotta know his limitations, you see. I have a right to laugh at that bullshit, because I invented it all. I don't remember when, though. But that don't matter. What matters is that even I keep the facade up when there's slaves around. And anyone so crass as to publicly, in public, offend the Holy Flame, is an enemy. Is that clear? You people should learn subtlety. Then we might even cooperate. I doubt you were sent here for nothing, after all. I've been watching your odyssey closely, and I must say... What? Ah, yes. Was it you who stole our water, Bowser? No. Don't bother denying it. I know everything. Well, hey, no harm, no foul. The slaves will have to drink a bit less for some time, that's all. Do you really expect my double would even consider not topping up his swimming pool over that trifle? Power must dazzle with extravagant displays of affluence. Even the comedian sitting on my throne understands this. All the slaves will have to die of thirst before the Baron cuts his morning shower time to half an hour. For such is the will of the Holy Flame. The main lesson from this fiasco will be learned by the cretins that let you pull this heist off. And the Bowser is a minuscule price to pay. If that makes them to start treating the task of guarding the only source of fresh water in the area with due diligence. The lesson made even more convincing by the punishment you personally delivered to the culprits in question. I must say, thank you for acting on my behalf. Hmm. Well, as far as I can see, you've been keeping busy. Subtlety, not your strong suit, young man. Didn't you help that witch escape from the lighthouse? Oh, don't shy away from taking credit. It was all part of the plan. If not for you, she would have been rescued by Sol's men. Everything must look natural after all. Gyul will kill the accursed Baron. The oppressed people will rebel. They will be headed by the new leaders of the resistance. Gyul will by right take the tyrant's place. Many of his old flunkies will swear allegiance to her. At that moment, she will discover that in addition to their freedom, the slaves will have gained hunger and thirst. Gyul knows nothing of the effort it takes to supply all my subjects with the barest of necessities. And when they, dying of hunger, with parched throats, start praying for the holy flame to save them, I will rise from the dead. And I will be their salvation. Such is the will of the holy flame, young man. Such is the will of the universe. The holy flame. When did I get the idea, I wonder? It's a great idea, too. No matter, as long as I had it.
Artyom, we took a look around. The main gate is guarded by a skeleton crew.
You cannot go through gate. Go through the prison cellar where the Munai Bailaire keep the slaves.
yes. In any case, the plan is this. Gyul and I will try to take their guards down quietly and get in through the gate. If quiet does not work out, we will at least distract them, while you get in through the underground. Let's go. We'll walk with you.
Don't lag behind. I have a favor to ask. If possible, don't kill the slaves. They're not... They just obey the Munai Bailaire. Obey the Baron. They're afraid, that's all.
Gyul is right about the locals.
Here. This place.
They're just kids, and all have been under brainwashing for ages. So we probably should take pity on them. So, agreed? Well, let's do this. All right, I'll raise it and you get through. Come on, this shit is heavy. Great. See you up there.
Let's go, Damir.
No use. Nobody go. Nobody pull. We stand here all day. You suck. Better go hunt, find some food, make slave, more use that way.
Dog and laugh. dog can't grow, get eaten by other dogs.
Also bad news.
The gate is locked and we can't take it out. Colonel, sir, Damir here. We have secured the tank, but encountered a problem with the gate.
Copy that. We're going with plan B then. Act accordingly.
See, the cable connects the gate and the top of the tower. How do we get there, though? Oh, it looks like a veritable fortress.
Gentlemen, surely you're not seriously intending to attack our fortress. I do respect your courage, but simply throwing your lives away, such a waste. Who is in charge between you two? Come up here. We have things to discuss.
Just you listen to this bastard talk. A complete about-face. And we did throw a wretched into his plans big time.
Point that gun down and come up. Otherwise, we'll have a pointless bloodbath on our hands. Open the gate and let our guests in! Come up! We won't even touch you! Unless you really ask for it.
I don't like this, but there is no other way. If we don't get out of this desert, we're as good as dead.
The
luck, Artyom. If the deal goes south, I'll do what I can.
Talk? What's there to talk with them about?
Damn, there's too many of them to count.
The Baron called me.
Hagers, slaves, even some women.
If I fucking hear one more word about that bitch, kill!
A penthouse, get that's the here. Word.
Go around them stinkers and just get to the next floor. The boss hates stench. Don't you fucking catch it from him.
My good work and let me fight too.
Come on, why the fuck does it take so long? You could do it with your eyes closed, I know that! Will you stop bugging me? I'm making something for the boss here. So if you don't like something, take it up to him. He didn't have to cut in the line before you after all.
Well, look. I can't really live without my flamer. I'll get you some parts. You'll finish it in time for the raid, I'll give you half my loot. Deal?
Ha! You must be one of the train gang!
Just you take a fucking look at the beauty Vint is making for the boss. It's not just any old sort of wheels, I tell you. Of course, we only get to look at it. Shit.
You fucking blind or what? Fix that shit! And you think? Come on. Stand up.
Well, you just fucking pull it! Put there. Your back into it! Why the fuck did we feed you yesterday? Fuck him the fuck before he sets us all on fire!
That one sure got fired over his stupidity!
Set it down, dude.
Fuck me, are they dumb? Third one is weak to bring their bastards.
I'm sorry, master. I'm your slave. Was not on purpose.
Shut up! I'll teach you how to serve now!
Sorry, master. Don't teach, please.
Shut the fuck up!
Why, master, man? Make me warrior. I want you.
Look, you go up that ladder. Past the headquarters, then past the harem, and you'll end up right at the boss's door.
Why are we even standing around here? Is there anything worth guarding?
Come on! What's taking so long? Come over here already!
Yes, you fucking look at that. The whore drank master's water. Gonna give her a lesson.
Forgive
now.
Me, Ulimirsa.
You're a dog!
Shut the fuck
less
up!
Less than a dog! The water is for people!
Fuck!
For the master! Do you get it?
Come on, up the ladder
you.
With you. The boss don't like waiting.
Fool. Get your ass over here!
It's one of those new arrivals.
Comes to lick the boss here.
They did Dusty and the boys in, and now think the boss is gonna let them off the hook.
What's the hook?
Yeah.
Is that even a dance?
Keep on drink.
I'm almost done.
Come on, move it!
Hey, pretty boy. Yeah, did you come on. From afar?
You're the one to see the boss? Come on in.
Don't waste boss time here.
Did you expect a different reception? Alter your weapon. Here we can talk without the masks. I trust everyone present implicitly. I find it weird they're not really bothered by your little mischief.
Well, you see,
this world is a harsh and chaotic one.
I'm just doing my best to introduce a little order into it. Without which, there is no hope for something better in the future. And with no hope, you can't live. But let us cut to the chase. You definitely did not come here to enjoy the scenery. Ergo, you have a goal. And that goal is probably far from here. I respect people with a purpose in life. So, I'm ready to provide you with fuel for your journey. I'm not asking for much in return. Surrender Gyul to me. Bring her to me, and we all win. I have Gyul, you will have your fuel. Everyone gets to live long and prosper. Now.
Gyul herself has come for you! You'll answer for everything!
Do you think I'm a fool? You didn't want a deal. Now you will all die. Starting with you, Gyul. Kill them!
Artyom, get ready. Get ready. We must kill these dogs.
it all out here, didn't you?
You wanted to create a new world with this? Not happening! Your misguided attempt!
I called her! Take the Baron!
It's the strongest who survives!
Your head's in the way.
You gave my people hope. I'll never forget it. But this war has only started for me, and I must see it to the end. The winning end.
Let's go, Artyom. Thank you for helping my people. I'm in your debt forever.
You're back, my love. I was so worried.
Fanatics on the banks of Volca. Cannibals in the mountain bunker. Slavers on the shores of the dried-out sea. How many monsters has the war given rise to? Or perhaps were they always there? And the war simply gave them a chance to show themselves, and now we're stuck with them forever. Regardless, we can't afford to lose hope. We are getting ever closer to our dream. Finding a place where we could live, free from radiation and mutants. The maps we recovered in the desert have provided us with several promising options. And now the crew members are excitedly waiting for the Colonel's decision on where the Aurora should go next. Currently, though, the train is calmly rolling eastward. The crew rests, and Stepan proposed to Katya. It was a proposal she couldn't refuse.
We've left those sands long ago, and it still persists. What does Crest even smoke? It's terrible. In any case, I'm better now.
I hate to interrupt, guys, but you should come to the mess hall. The table is almost served.
Thanks, Stepan. We'll be there in a moment. Shall we go, Artyom? Or shall we stay a little longer? It's so nice. You know, Artyom, I've been looking at Stepan and Katya, you and me, and thinking how lucky we are. It was so different with my parents. It was bad. Did I ever tell you why my mom died? Of course I didn't. It was because of Dad. He used to be even harsher back then. He used to come home from the barracks and reach for the bottle while taking off his boots. They'd quarrel, and then he'd stop appearing for a time. And while he was away, she'd start drinking too, and crying when she was sober. She'd feel better, would get kind of dreamy when drunk. You know how she used to call me, just A. She'd hug me and say, "One day, A, you and I are going to go to Vladivostok, the city I was born in. And from there to a village on the ocean shore." I was 5 back then and didn't really get much. But I could imagine that village and the ocean so vividly because I believed her. And then she killed herself, drank some kind of poison. Father quit drinking after Mom's death. Didn't ever pay much attention to me, but with her gone, he'd never leave me alone. Took me along everywhere. We only talked about her a couple of times, though. I used to have this doll, Jana. I played make-believe that she was my daughter, and we went to the ocean together. Then my father hid it, told me it got lost. He probably didn't want me to agonize over Mom's dream. Then I imagine she grew up and went to Vladivostok. And now I'm going, not to Vladivostok, but with you. The dream came true. By the way, I was always intrigued by what Dad dreams about. He should have some dreams, so what are they? Higher rank? He could choose any. Saving people? What would the saved do next? Sit underground? I never understood him. What does he hope for in life? What makes him happy? Nothing, perhaps. He never really had any time to think about tomorrow. Down in the metro, those thoughts don't come casually. Here on the surface, though. I, for one, have something I want to do. I want to run through the sand barefoot. Build a sandcastle for the kids. I'm imagining two. A boy and a girl. The boy would be a copy of you. We'd go swimming with mountains behind us. Wooden houses on the shore. The sun would wake us up every day, rising from the ocean. That harbor is our destination. Worth going there, even if we have half the world to cross. Everyone should have a destination. A point on the map where they aspire to go, and where one could finally be happy. All our guys have their own. We broke out of the metro and are now starting to scatter. Not at once, of course. At first, we're all still running together, searching. But eventually, each of us will find a point like this and stay there. I don't know where my dad's destination is. Don't know where yours is either. But I know I love you. A whole lot. Go, Artyom. I'll rest some more and join you later.
Station here. Station, come in. Over.
Station here.
Over. Oh my god, it's Tina! What did I miss you? Over.
Are you calling just to tell me that?
Over. I just didn't expect you to be on radio duty. Here's what I wanted to say. I'm coming back from Nizhny already. How are you guys doing in Cheboksary? Over.
Well, doing all right, considering the radiation and all. Over.
Well, be nice. See that you're in no mood for chatter today, even though I have news. The locals did end their scuffle after all. Well, I'll tell you more when I'm back. Over.
Not in the mood? It's just that we have news here too, so come over quickly if you don't want to miss all the fun.
I see. I'm gonna run then. Over and out.
Good luck with your marathon. Over and out.
Come in. It's me, Dimon. Abbas, where the hell are you? Come in.
Dimon, why so much fuss? Why you expect me to answer the second you call?
Because of the frequency we're on, that's why. It's always jammed with the fucking art project bullshit.
You no need to worry about that. It's gone now.
Gone? I thought that with so many fools going there and never coming back, it would be going on forever.
I think some fool actually got there. Broke the record and all.
Fat fucking chance of that. I'd say whatever's been gobbling them fools up is just full now and is getting some Z's for digestion.
That may be, but now we can talk here and nobody will know.
Yes, we can. So, what was that you wanted to talk about?
You hear about that meet? Yes?
I have. Not that I'm invited. I'll just stay here and wait for one of the two bosses to come hire me and my boys. How about you?
Me too. My people, they want some action and fat payout. And this is chance by the Holy Flame. And hear what I want to talk about. How about we work together?
Ah, good thinking. I don't want to fight you anymore.
I don't want to fight you too. That knee still hurts. So, what you say, old friend?
I'm in. We need to talk in person now. A good deal likes privacy, and even though this frequency seems secure...
Yes, I understand. Let us meet tomorrow. At the old restaurant, what you say? Huh?
Deal. See you there, Abbas. Over and out.
Rachmet, my friend. Over and out.
Brothers and sisters, the Baron, that old dog, is dead. I killed him myself. All of the Munaibai Lair are confused now, like headless chickens. Our day has come. Fight them. Fight them however you can. Come with the Baron's rig used to be. Come and we'll give you weapons. You served those dogs for too long. And what did you get in return? Only cruelty, death, and the Holy Flame, which I spit at. It is time to chase them away from our land for good now. All of our land, all oil, all food will be ours. Death to the Munaibai Lair.
Thank you. What do you know?
Everything is perfect, Artyom. Follow us.
Friends? Wow, you have lots of intel.
Artyom, sit somewhere nearby.
But now I simply must talk. I have to warn you about Stepan. He is incredibly, disgustingly nice and kind-hearted. Yes, no, indeed. I, as a misanthrope of Nor, am appalled.
What did I miss?
You should have seen them dance.
Don't you worry, you'll get another chance.
A moment of your attention, please. Half a year on the road, and 4,000 clicks behind us. We have been through a lot. All right, people. I do understand I can't keep it a secret much longer. After a careful study of the satellite maps we've obtained, and much deliberation, we've found a place we could call our new home. It is a river valley. There's forest and a hydroelectric power plant.
Yeah.
This place is quite far from densely populated areas, which, as our journey has proven, is important. We're about 2 days away from it now. So, congratulations, everyone!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yet, this is not our last order of business for today. Stepan, Katya.
Oh, rings!
Stepan, Katya, repeat after me. I take you to be my spouse.
I take you to be my spouse.
And vow to hold you from this day forward.
And vow to
for
hold
better,
you from this
or
day
for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish
to and
until
cherish
death
do us part.
Do us part. As the captain of this ship, I hereby pronounce you husband and wife. Live long and be happy. Oh, and
Gorka!
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 Oh!
What are you talking about, baby?
In the Yamantau, when they dragged me away, that ghoul doctor said my lungs were falling apart. The gas I breathed in that ammo dump said I
How can
have
you
lungs.
Believe that monster? We've just been through a desert and all that sand, so that might be the reason. Katya, Artyom, a few words.
Go. I'm fine now.
I don't know about this. The old man is furious.
Artyom's getting chewed out today.
It's not Artyom's fault. I fell into that stupid bunker all by myself. And if Dad says one word to him about it, I'll tear him a new one.
Yes, this is getting old. As soon as something happens, it's always Artyom's fault, even when he had nothing to do with it.
That's just his fate. Fate? Get out of here!
Yes, in any case, Katya will calm the Colonel down. You shouldn't worry either, Anna. She'll fix you in no time at all. She's good.
Let us not panic and think constructively.
So, Katya, what do you think?
I think that trusting some degenerate's diagnosis wouldn't be wise. A move from humid metro into the desert with its dry heat and sandstorms is a stress for lungs.
Yes, I do think she'd be hit really bad right off the start had it been
gas. My thoughts exactly. Thus, first I'll check her condition to the best of my knowledge. Also, we're approaching the valley with its forest air. That alone could heal her.
I'm sorry to intervene, but did something happen?
Anna coughed up some blood.
My God. Do you really think it's the sand? Sounds more like TB to me. That's for sure.
TB we can handle. We've got enough antibiotics, and air does help with that.
What if that degenerate was right, Katya? What do we do? Is there medicine?
There was an air defense battery station in our village. Right on the brink of war, they received a new drug. It saved a lot of people after gas exposure and general poisoning. I'll check my mom's records and find its name. I think it was produced in Novosibirsk.
Right, Novosibirsk. Yermak, your opinion. For Anna's sake, I'd go to the edges of the earth. As for Novosibirsk, it's about 2,000 leagues.
Then it's decided. We head for the valley. If it is suitable, we settle there. If Anna's state worsens, I'll take a group of volunteers to find that drug. So Katya, please, find that name for
us. I'll find it. Don't worry.
One more thing, Artyom. I want no surprises in that valley. You are our most seasoned scout. So take the rail car, one volunteer. Go check everything out before we arrive. Let's go back for now. Tell Anna and the people to calm down. Now I understand why she is so down lately. Just imagine thinking about all that for so long.
I can't say I've ever been religious, but right now I'm begging all gods, please, watch over Anna and make the valley cure her of her affliction. In the meantime, Alyosha and I are on a recon mission. We have no idea of what is waiting for us there. though Alyosha seems convinced that there are going to be crowds of women eagerly anticipating his arrival. If that turns out to be the case, then I have the best companion possible for this mission.